Hi, my name's Coop, and in this video we're asking, what is SQL used for? Let's get started. SQL stands for Structured Query Language. Some people like to quibble about whether it's pronounced SQL or SQL, but the truth is both are correct. You should pick one and use it confidently. SQL is the language for talking to relational databases. It's been used by millions of people since 1986 and provides the user with CRUD functionality. The user can create data in a database, read it, update it, and delete it. SQL is a cornerstone of data processing, and by extension, the modern business world. Its usefulness means you'll meet many SQL users who don't have the word data in their job title. A SQL query to access rows of data follows a predictable format. Select requests a column of tabular data. From specifies the table to access. Where sets conditions for inclusion. Group by aggregates the resulting rows into groups, and order by and limit determine how the data is ordered and limited in count. All the commands after the second line are optional, but when present, they are always in that order. And these are just the basics. Don't worry about memorizing this. You'll get practice with it later. SQL also provides some simple mathematical functions out of the box: average, min, max, sum, count, and several trigonometric functions. It can also be configured to access more complex machine learning algorithms and predictive models, but that's not native to SQL itself. The analysis we can perform inside SQL itself is somewhat limited in that way. However limited, it's a dependable workhorse. You can save and reuse a good query indefinitely, using it as a single source of truth for a particular question. That means SQL can give you fresh data in a consistent format. Since its introduction, many sublanguages of SQL have been introduced. These add features for convenience, security, distributed computing, and more. Once you learn the basics of SQL, it's not too hard to learn another SQL sublanguage, like MySQL or Postgres. Now, maybe you're thinking, that's cool, but what will I use it for? I can't tell the future, but I can enumerate some ways that businesses use SQL for data analysis. First, SQL can be used to gather metrics. This is one of the most common uses of SQL you'll encounter. Businesses define their goals with key performance indicators, or KPIs. KPIs are important facts that can't be measured directly, such as customer retention, product usage, feature usage, profit per region, and lifetime customer value. Related things that we can measure directly are called metrics, and those measurements are often stored in databases. For example, e-commerce companies collect many types of data about user behavior on the site, and combine measurements about them to infer something about the customer relationship. Much of this analysis starts with SQL. Sometimes you'll be tasked with gathering metrics about a particular kind of question, and you'll need to carefully select relevant segments of the data using SQL. Another common use of SQL is data mining. Many companies collect so much data that they literally don't know what to do with it. So they pour it into a semi-structured data storage called a data lake. Data mining is the process of extracting useful knowledge from data where it may or may not be found. Finding hidden patterns in the data can be immensely rewarding, but it's a skill with a very high ceiling. Learning an advanced search technique, like regular expressions, can help you level up your SQL data mining skills. Here's an example of a regular expression that finds email addresses in a block of text. I know it looks incredibly complex, but once you learn a little bit about regular expressions, it's not scary at all. SQL can also be used for gap analysis. This is a more strategic element of business intelligence, but still applicable in the analysis realm. Gap analysis is the process of identifying how well an organization's outcomes align with its expectations, and what steps are necessary to improve the situation. This might involve close inspection of failure cases and looking for unusual metrics. A report based on that kind of analysis can suggest a new course of action or new avenues for data collection. One last use of SQL is called business rule analysis. This is about investigating the internals of a business's operations. Managers and executives are very interested to learn whether their goals are actually being achieved, and whether their decisions are having secondary side effects. Business rules are indicators built in SQL that can help measure the health of a business's operations. All told, this set of uses is very focused on business intelligence. In practice, the majority of your queries will be simple to write and primarily used to extract data to another tool. But even basic SQL usage can streamline your analysis and get you consistent results in the long run. There's plenty of ways to improve on just reading from a database. There's always more to learn, so stay curious.